Welcome to Optical Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain comparison in between avalanche photodiode and PIN photodiode. And here I'll be doing comparison of these two diode. You can see my previous videos where I have already explained in detail these two diodes, PIN photodiode as well as avalanche photodiode. That is there in my playlist of Optical Fiber Communication. So you can go through individual separate videos for both. Even here we will compare these two diode with different parameters. So first parameter is how layers are arranged over here. So layers for PIN photodiode, we have already seen it is arranged as per P plus, I and N plus. So that is how layers are arranged in this PIN photodiode. When we talk about avalanche photodiode, so it is arranged as per P plus, pi, P and N plus. So this is how layers are arranged in avalanche photodiode. Now what about gain of PIN diode? So here gain is not provided in PIN diode, or one can say gain is always less than 1. So gain is not provided, or one can say gain is always less than 1, and here gain is provided with very huge magnitude. It could be around 200. So more gain is provided. I'm not writing 200. The reason is, for different avalanche photodiode, gains are different. But you'll be finding with avalanche photodiode, huge gain could be possible. Now next is amplifier requirement. So basically, in PIN photodiode, you'll be observing generated photocurrent that will be very less. So before we use that received light signal in terms of current, we should be amplifying that. So usually you'll be finding amplifier requirement that is always there with PIN photodiode. So it is highly required. In PIN photodiode, while avalanche photodiode that is providing gain, so you don't need amplifier, so it is not required in case of avalanche photodiode. So it is not required here. Now see response time. So when we talk about response time, it is very less in case of PIN diode, but it is more in case of avalanche photodiode. So response time that is very less in case of PIN photodiode, and it is more in case of avalanche photodiode. Now output current. So as I have told, see gain is actually not there, or one can say gain is less than 1. So output current will be less. So less output current is there. While in case of avalanche photodiode, it is having very high gain. So output current will be high. So high output current is there with avalanche photodiode. Now see, when we talk about noises, so different noises like photon noise, short noise, Johnson noise, and generation of recombination noise is there with PIN diode. So let me mention that over here. Noises like photon noise, short noise, Johnson noise, and generation recombination noise. So these are the noises which is there in pin photodiode: photon noise, short noise, Johnson noise, and generation recombination noise, that is there with pin photodiode. While in case of avalanche photodiode, there is short noise, thermal noise, and avalanche noise. So it is having short noise, thermal noise, and avalanche noise is there. And when we compare overall noise generated in these two devices, then pin photodiode is having less noise compared to avalanche photodiode. So overall noise that will be high in case of avalanche photodiode, and it will be low in case of pin photodiode. But you will be finding these are the noises which is available in these two devices. Now, next parameter is sensitivity. So when we talk about sensitivity, pin photodiode is less sensitive. So pin photodiode is less sensitive, while avalanche photodiode, that is highly sensitive. So minor change will change higher amount of fluctuation at output side in case of avalanche photodiode, but in case of pin photodiode, minor change will not provide huge change at output side, so it is less sensitive. So pin photodiode is less sensitive and avalanche photodiode is highly sensitive. Now what is the reverse bias? See, photodiode always works in reverse bias, right? So what is reverse bias voltage which we apply it in pin photodiode and avalanche photodiode? So see, in pin photodiode you can work with very low reverse bias voltage. So very low reverse bias voltage that could be given. But in case of avalanche photodiode, to have avalanche effect, we will be working with reverse bias voltage around breakdown voltage. So extremely high reverse bias voltage is given. So here we give reverse bias voltage nearer to breakdown voltage. So reverse bias voltage nearer to breakdown voltage, that we are giving it in case of avalanche photodiode. Now what is temperature stability? So temperature stability in pin photodiode is very good. So good temperature stability is there with pin photodiode, while it is poor temperature stability, it is having poor temperature stability with avalanche photodiode. So temperature stability is poor in case of avalanche photodiode, and temperature sensitivity, that is good in case of pin photodiode. So here I have compared these two diode with different parameters based on layers. Pin is P plus I N plus, avalanche is P plus pi P N plus. Gain, so gain is not there with pin, or one can say less than one. Avalanche photodiode is having gain, that is very high. It could be there in terms of hundreds. Amplifier requirement is always there with pin photodiode as signal is low. And in case of avalanche photodiode, it is not required as it is having more gain. Response time is very less in case of pin photodiode, while it is more in case of avalanche photodiode. Output current is less in pin photodiode and it is high in avalanche photodiode. If you see different noises, then photon noise, short noise, Johnson noise, saturation recombination, generation recombination noise, that is there with pin photodiode. While in case of avalanche photodiode, short noise, thermal noise, avalanche noise is there. But overall noise in avalanche photodiode is high compared to pin photodiode. Sensitivity is less in case of pin photodiode and it is highly sensitive with avalanche photodiode. In pin photodiode, it can work with low reverse bias voltage, but avalanche photodiode works at breakdown, nearer to breakdown voltage. So it in reverse bias, it works nearer to breakdown voltage. So temperature stability is very good with pin photodiode, while it is poor with avalanche photodiode. So these are the comparison parameters. And that is how one can compare these two diodes. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll make videos which will solve all those queries that is there with students, and that will be helpful to other students, those who are learning from my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.